Hi everybody, my name is Krishna and I have close to 14 years of IT experience, and with respect to training I have close to 12 years of training experience. Okay, so let's start with our actual agenda, which is on Python regex. So this is our agenda of our discussion is this. So we will talk about what is Python, then we will discuss about what are regular expressions, why do we really need it, then we will talk about what are the regular expressions you can do in Python. What is the regular expression? What are the different kinds of functions you have in regular expression? Then what is the different kinds of things you can do in regular expression? Then we will do a small example on how to identify email and phone number verification. And we'll understand how we can we use regular expression in web scraping as well. So this is going to be our discussion topic today. Okay, first, what is Python? So Python was created by a guy called Guido van Rossum. Basically, he's an applied mathematician in 1991. And actually the name Python came from a episode comedy series which he used to watch. It's just a summer intern project which he was doing, and figured out that he can make it big, and that's where he actually end up creating a language, and he want to trying to figure out what is the name I should put. Then he realized Python is a good name to do, and he just put the episode name. It is not people like show the snake and all, nothing like that. It is the name of a series. You can search in Monty Python. That's like used to be a famous comedy circus episode in British in BBC. So basically Python is a high level. So when I say high level, you can write in English language. That's what they mean by high level. And it's a general purpose programming language. So when I say general purpose, it is not a language which is domain specific. When I say domain specific, like you have languages like MATLAB, you have languages like Fortran, you have languages like COBOL. Everything has one purpose. Fortran is used for scientific application, COBOL for business, and MATLAB is purely again on the scientific side. They are like domain specific. They are built for a purpose. That means they have a specific purpose only. They can be used for other use cases also, but the main theme of building them is for that particular use case. So, but Python is not like that. Python can fit in any area. You can use in testing, you can use in data science, you can use in ML, you can use in automation, you can use in administration, anything. That's why the name general purpose, you can use it anything. And it uses two type of approaches for programming. One is procedural programming. Procedural programming is nothing but what you do in C, where you break up your program into different functions and write the code. Whereas when you say object-oriented programming, it's more about you actually identify the data, tie up your functions with it, then start the interaction between objects, all that kind of thing. That's what comes under object-oriented approach. And Python is both. Both it uses object-oriented as well as procedural programming. You can use any style which you like. There's no hard and fast rule. If you see Java, you have to use only object-oriented, but Python doesn't put any rules. You can use always whichever programming paradigm you like it, you can always use it. And it uses indentation to describe the blocks of code. That means like in other languages, it's not like that flower braces kind of thing. So let me quickly show what I mean by that. So for example, if you see in other languages, like anything you want to write, like if you want to write in Java, you will write something like this. And you have to put up flower braces to indicate that this is the program starting and this is the program ending. Something like that you end up writing, right? So here there's no, if you want to write the same thing in Python, the way to do it is you will write like this. Here indentation is the key, like this. So there is no flower braces, no nothing like that concept. So that's what they mean by indentation here. Okay, so it just follows based on this number of spaces. Indentation is nothing but the proper number of spaces you give actually. So based on that, it goes and understands what you are writing and all that. So now what is regular expression? So regular expression, basically you can consider it like a language. It's basically a pattern matching language. That means, let's say, generally, let's talk about regular expression in general. If I say, you have to fetch me, let's say you have HTTP. xyz.com website and the product ID one, like this is there, like that. Assume you have lot of product IDs in the website is like this. Okay, these are just two URLs I'm saying. Like that, assume that there are hundreds of URLs will be like that. Now whenever I ask you to get a product ID, let's say for example, What is the pattern you look at? You can see the pattern is there will be a website which starts with HTTP, then there is xyz.com, then there is a slash, then there is this guy. This is what you are interested in. This is what you fetch. And that is the same pattern you can apply here also, right? So you can say, just hypothetically, I'm showing. We will see programmatically, but hypothetically think the use case. So this is what we are interested in, right? I just put a parenthesis to say that is the part I am interested in. So if I fetch this, don't you think I can fetch all the different product ID from this list of set of URLs given like this? So what I am exactly doing here, I'm exactly figuring out a pattern, and this is my pattern. It will start with http://xyz.com/. There is a parenthesis, and that is whatever it is there. I mean, it could be PID1, it could be PID2. That's what I'm going to back capture. So this is the pattern. And the teach this kind of pattern to programming languages, it is not just to Python. Any programming language to teach these kind of pattern, you have a concept called regular expression. Regular expression exactly does that. So it is like a pattern matching. So you can put a pattern just like how I showed. That kind of pattern, it can look at it and get the thing required. That is the whole objective of regular expression. It is basically a pattern matching programming language. It is a programming language is like a wrong term to use. We can say a pattern matching language. That's the right term. It is actually embedded as part of all your languages. You can see regular expression in Java. You can see regular expression in C#, C#. Anywhere you go, that regular expression topic will be there because it's a language by itself. Whereas people call it regular expression engine also, everything is same. So that is what it is. Okay, and it is introduced by a scientist called Stephen Colclean. If you guys have studied mathematics, if you guys have studied computer science, you will have a subject called theory of automation. There, one of the main key topic is regular expression. It's actually the foundation is from mathematics again. Somebody is saying my voice is not audible. Was it the case for others or it is just one person? For some reason, regex is quite complicated or complex. Used need to uncomplicate the regex concept. It is not complex instruction. Simple thing. All you have to understand is, I hope you understand the hypothetical example I have given. Given a URL, you have to fetch the PIDs. That's all. Now, what is the pattern you form? Generally, think about it. Don't think about any programming language. And whatever you're doing is nothing but pattern matching. That's what regular expression helps you to do that. That's all. It is not complicated. It is the way people take it is different. If you understand the concept clearly, it is very easy. Okay, so it's just a pattern matching thing. And you understand, like, you know, you have seen why we need regular expression, right? Just a simple example I have given. In URL, you have a product ID 1, product ID 2. If you want to fetch, how do you fetch it? So we ourselves able to come up with a pattern. The same thing is what the existence of regular expression. There are a lot of use cases. One use case could be, like, let's say, for example, we will see this example also, but I'm just giving you. Let's say somebody showed you something like this, names, and they asked you to fetch the names from this, only names. This is a HTML page, which I'm going to show you in a while. If they ask you to show it, you have to just fetch the names and rank. So from HTML page, how you will parse it? So you will put a pattern. If you look at it, it's a pure HTML page where everywhere, how do you fetch it? Like if you see, all this data will be here in this HTML page. Whatever it just shown was the HTML, right? It will be there here. If you go down and check it. So the same thing, we are going to use regular expression to fetch it by putting some patterns. So it's just a pattern matching programming language, nothing more than that. And there are different ways to fetch patterns and all. Okay. If a pattern is not matched, what it will happen? If a pattern is not matched, either it will just be an empty. Okay. It will just say, I don't have any answer. We will see that. Don't worry. Okay. If it doesn't match, it will not say anything. It is like indicating I didn't find the pattern. Okay. So why do we need regular expression? Pattern matching, simple. You can do searches, everything and all. That's very easy here. Like these are the use cases which we already seen. Okay, so to verify the structure of string. So when I say pattern matching, just think about what we can do in pattern matching. In pattern matching, you can structure the string just like how you structure the URL, right? And you can fetch the substring. I will show you how to do that. But if you are able to, like I said, from the product ID, how to fetch it, I showed you how you are actually putting some parentheses and all. So that is the way in regular expression also we do, where you fetch something out of it. And you can search, replace, rearrange parts of the string, which means you can get what you want. You can search for what you want. In that, you can fetch what is the required thing also by putting some functions. But the whole concept is you are matching a pattern first. Like this is how the flow happens. You match a particular pattern you want in a website or a string. And once that match occurs, you can do a lot. You can either say, okay, pattern match, which is called search, or you can say, okay, pattern match, now get me that. That is called the substring extraction part. And third one, you can say, okay, pattern matched, now replace it with something else. So that is that replacing part. Like that, you can do a lot. And you can even split a string with multiple tokens. All that is pretty possible. But the first thing you can always remember is pattern match. That is what need to happen. Only when it matches, it gives you the answer. Otherwise, it will be just keep quiet. Okay, so that is what the whole goal of regular expression is. Now, how do we do regular expressions in Python? Like I showed you, here what this guy is doing. So he is fetching this Python is from this. But if you see how he is fetching, you can observe there is one pattern. There is a less than p greater than, and there is this greater than. This is a HTML tag inside it. This text is embedded. And that is the exact text he's getting it by removing this hyperlinks, everything and all. Okay, so this is like a pattern matching thing. And in Python to do it, what we have? In Python, we have a module or library using which you can get these regular expressions done. That guy name is Ari. Okay, so if there is an error, he will throw an exception. But if there is no match, he will just keep quiet. That means it will give an empty string. But if there is a match, he will respond with some data. That is how RE work. RE stands for regular expression, and it's a module or library in Python. For your information, for people who don't know what is a module or library, module or library is simply a reusable program. That means the program is not written just for us or just for our use cases. It is something which can be useful for anybody. So like regular expression, it can be useful for me. It can be useful for you. Those kind of programs, if they write, that is where you call them as library or reusable programs or modules. Okay. Regular expression once again. So regular expression is nothing but a pattern matching programming language. Okay. So it's just a pattern matching programming language. Do we have any built-in method or formats by which we can extract the dates? Exactly. See, Dinesh, understand they haven't defined for dates or specific format. You have to write that pattern. We will see that one by one. First, let's understand what are the functions available. So these are the functions available in regular expression. There is a match, search, find all, split, sub. So what does match and search do? The exact same thing, no difference. More than that, I would recommend using search, because I'll tell you how match works is. Match actually starts matching whatever regular expression, whatever pattern you have given from the beginning. But let's say you want to find a match inside a string. Okay, then that's not possible. Like for example, let me show you how the match and this works. So first thing, in order to use regular expression, this is the library I have to use, import RE. Once you do that, now before this, like for example, you want to match it. So I'm using some symbols. So before this, I need to show you something. I mean, you need to, in order to learn regular expression, you need to know some symbols meanings. Like for example, in regular expression, whenever people put star, understand that means zero or more occurrences of a given string. Okay, when they put question mark, it means zero or one occurrences. That's what they mean. I'll explain when I'm using it, but these basics you should be aware of. These are the basic things you should be knowing it. This means one or more occurrences of given string. And you know, after that there is backslash d, which means there is this symbol also sometimes people use, which means any number from 0 to 9 digit, any digit, that is the correct term, from 0 to 9 characters. I mean, it could be any digit. The same thing you can represent with backslash d. Either you say backslash d or this, this is one and the same. Similarly, sometimes people say backslash w, sometimes people say backslash s. So backslash w is nothing but either characters from capital A to Z or capital A to Z or 0 to 9 or underscore. So it means when you use backslash W, it can match to any of the lowercase alphabets from small letter A to small letter Z. It can match any character from capital letter A to capital letter Z, or it can match any character from 0 to 9 digits. And backslash n means single or multiple space match. That is what these symbols you should be aware of when we use the symbols. So that's why you want to clarify. That is important. And that is required for every language, not just for this. Okay, so these are the symbols you are aware. Now let's see with the symbols we know what we can do. Like you see here, what I'm doing exactly here is backslash w plus. So backslash w means, like I said, any character from, what did I say just now? Any character from 0 to 9 digit or small a to z or capital A to z or underscore. That's what I said, right? The same thing here, but you put plus. That means it can occur one or more times. That is what it means. So that's how you combine things here. So you see here what I'm trying to match. I'm trying to match XYZ, because if you see XYZ is an alphabetic, it has small a to z. I'm forming a pattern if you really see. And after that, there is at the rate. So that's what I said. Backslash W plus means it will match all the lowercase or numbers or whatever. You email at the rate before it could be anything. So I put a pattern saying backslash W plus means you can match any of these. Then I have said after that there will be at the rate. I'm creating a pattern if you observe. Then I put again backslash W plus, which means any of this one or more times. Okay, that's what I mean by backslash W plus. And after that, there is a dot. That dot is to indicate this. Then for com also I have put that. Now who is matching exactly? If you see a pattern, anything after that at the rate, anything after it at the dot, after it anything. So this is the only guy which matches it. Okay, so that's why it fetches me that. Okay, so if you see here when I run it, okay, I need to run this guy first. So when I ran it, it said that this is the match I got it, right? Now what here happens is, now if you observe two things, you have to observe. I have put R, like somebody asked. So when I say R, R simply means use the symbol as it is. Like if you don't put R, what will happen is there are some special symbols. Like for example, in regular expression also, dot means, in regular expression when you use dot means, I mean it's a big subject, there are a lot of symbols. I just explained only the one required, given that we have only 1 hour of time. So dot means, dot represents any character other than new line. So it represents anything. But now how you want to use dot, you want to use dot like as it is. I mean, because there is a dot and you don't want it to represent. That's why I have put R. So that time what would happen is it will not take the actual meaning of regular expression, but it fetches like it is, like you have put it, like on the face. That means on the face, it is just a full stop, right? It will take as it is. That's why the R is. So R is actually stands for raw string. Whenever you put R before any regular expression, it means raw string. That's what it means. Now, the second thing you need to observe is, see this one, you should have asked me this question. This one also is matching and this one also should match. There should be two occurrences, right? Why it stopped at the beginning? That is another question you have to ask me. Now, first thing, understand when it really matches what it gives. When it really matches, this is what it gives. So it tells you, yes, there is a match happened, and it tells from where to where the match happened. So it is giving the character number. If you count, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, like that, it counts it. So where to where the character match is happening is telling us. So it says from 6th character to 19th character, your match happened. And what is the match? And it said, this is the one. Now, this is how it will give you a string when it matches. When it doesn't match, it will not give anything. Okay. Now here, why the other thing didn't match this, understand the search or match, which was there in the slide, will help you to do only if the first match. As soon as the first one matched, they stop. They will not go beyond. That is how the match and search will work. Okay. If you want to get all the matches, the only answer is you can use another function called find all. See find all, if you do, it is matching and giving everything. So find all is your answer to give you all the matches. Search is for just to detect whether it is there. It doesn't matter how many times it is there, whether it is there or not. That's why in the beginning of the slide, it said you can search. The search is this. The search means this. You're just checking whether that pattern is there or not. That's all. You don't really care how many times it is there. But if you really care how many times it is there and you want to get all the matches, your answer is find all. All you need to do is just copy the same string as it is and give it. Find all will work. Here you can see it is giving me all the matches. Simple. So you see how simple it is. Like you can easily get, you can easily search what you want, and you can easily get all the ones you want, right? All the ones you want, just put find all. This is the function. If you want to just check whether what is that, is that really there? Because before even you fetching it, you cannot blindly apply it, right? Because when you blindly apply, you are assuming that it will always be there. But before that, it's a good check to see whether it already there. If it is already there, that means you can do fetching. That second part is what you can do this. So that is the best part of it. Okay. Now how split works is, now here you have simple, you have a string like this, and in that there are different delimiters. Like you have semicolon, you have pipe, you have colon, you have comma, all that. But you want to split with all these different delimiters. Now when you want it like this. Now If you use general split in Python, it takes only one separator, either semicolon or whatever. So you have to do it step by step. Rather than that, the advantage here with this guy is you can just apply re.split and give all the symbols you want in square brackets. And automatically it split your string and give you words like this. And this is very useful when you do log processing or whatever in real time, because log and all will have different information. So you can put all the delimiters using this re.split, and it automatically breaks the string for you and gives it like this. So once you get it as list, you can easily process it. That's the best part of the split. Now coming to sub. What sub do is, sub means substitution. So let's say this is my string, and in that you want to replace in with less than in. So there are a lot of ins you might see here. Like for example, in, there is in here like that. You want to replace all this with less than and all. So all you need to do is just say re.sub. Whenever you match this particular string, just replace with that. And when you run it, you can see wherever in is there. So sitting, sitting, it replaced with less than in, greater than in. So you can see a lot of places it replaced. So whichever place you want, you can automatically, it automatically substitutes. It is similar to your sed command in Unix. Okay. Okay. How to replace the particular insert? So particular in, you cannot do it. When you say particular in, you should know about that particular in. So when you say, when you are talking about only in, then what you have to do is, do we have in this example at least? Yeah, we have. So particular in, if you want. So now you see it is trying to do everywhere. There is something called boundaries. Let me put the boundaries here. Now you see it is replacing only the particular in, if I read it correctly. So you can see there should be in various. Okay, it is not replacing. See here, there is this in various here, in various and all. Only the particular in I replaced by putting backslashes before. So you have to tell the pattern saying before you there will be a space and after you there will be a space. So that is what I taught to it. So it understand that particular in it is replaced, because I told it before that there will be a space and after that there will be a space. So your pattern should also be correct when you are matching. If your pattern is correct, nobody can help. So that is how you can match a particular in. Now match object. Okay, so span we already discussed. Group we are going to discuss. String is like it just returns a string passed to the function. That's all. But we'll discuss, we'll look at the group. Okay, so let's see how the group will be helpful. Now, let's say, yep. So here, it matched perfectly fine. So when it matches re.search, what will give you? It will give you an object, but you have to fetch this, right? Whatever it is matched. Okay, it says it is a string matched, but it should give me only this. That is what I'm interested in. That's why I did the match. So the way to get it is, you have to just assign this particular whatever function you have written as search to a particular variable. Here I put re underscore object. It's just a variable. In that object, it will have ability to fetch a particular thing. So what and all it matched? It matched only one this, right? The first match. So it is matched only one. So the first match, if you want to say, all you have to say is group of one. That's all. So it will give you the first match saying, if there are multiple matches, then if you have to say group of two, you can get that. So group is basically a function to get the specific match. Because when you are doing regular expression, here I gave only one pattern. Sometimes you might end up giving multiple patterns. Like for example, here, let's say I have put like this. Now, this is like you are saying, I want to match this and extract for me. I want to match this and extract for me. So the match will happen, but the first match, this is the one, first match, second match, this is the one. Whatever you put in parentheses, that is what you are trying to extract. That's the whole goal is. Now, if you want to get the same thing here, you can just, okay, let me put it in this. Let me put it in a variable. Just put it as like object. And this object will have, so see, it matched only XYZ because I said I want this. So parenthesis is a way to say which one you want. So here we are saying we want this, then we want this. So this is your first match. This is your second match. So you just have to capture an object. Now you want to get the second match. You can just say object dot group of two. So you see, this is your first match, second match. So that is how the group is useful to fetch a particular matched objects. Okay. That object is of what data type? It is a regular expression object type. So if you want to check the type, you can just do this and it will tell you it is a regular expression object. So this is a RE match object. It's a basically a regular expression object. That's all. It's not a normal variable. Okay, so that is how you can do these things. Now we are talking about email and phone number. So let's see, email we already discussed. That is the first example we discussed, like how to fetch an email from a string. That is what we already discussed from the beginning. Phone number, let's look at phone number maybe. Phone number, yeah. So let's say this is our Indian phone numbers or US phone numbers also we will see. So let's say this is your Indian phone numbers. And as you know, Indian phone numbers are of 10 digit, isn't it? So these are the 10 digit number inside that you have strings also. So how to do that? So here what I'm doing, I'm saying re.search and I'm saying backslash D 10 comma 12 and get me the content. This is the content you need to look. Now it is not matching. Why? Let's see that. So what I am trying to say here is backslash D represents what? It represents a digit, isn't it? So when it represents a digit, I'm saying how many number of digits you can have. I'm saying you can have 10 to 12 digits. Actually, Indian phone numbers will have only 10 digits, but I've just put, just for our exercise, 10 to 12. So what I'm saying is any set of digit pattern which have 10 digits or 10 to 12, that means 10 digit or 11 digit or 12 digit. That is what I have said. The way to say it is just put flower braces. This is how many number of digits. So indirectly, rather than writing backslash D, backslash D, backslash D 12 times or 10 times, this is a shortcut way of saying any digit which is of a 10 character or 11 character or 12 character, get me all that. And what you can do, you can just put in find all and this guy will tell you all that. So how many digits this is there? This will be even more than that, right? And this will be lesser than that. So all that will fetch. That is how you can easily fetch telephone numbers. This is not only on that, on a particular website also, if you want, you can fetch that. Now this is on US phone numbers. Like US phone numbers generally will have three digits here, then there is a hyphen, then four digits, then there is hyphen, then three digits. So how to put it? So here also I'm applying the same technique, just that I'm not mentioning the range. Say I'm saying backslash D three times. The way to say three times is just put flower braces. Then I said hyphen, because there is a hyphen. And after that, the backslash D should be four times. So I said backslash D four times. Then I put hyphen, then I said backslash D three times. Then I put backslash D, that's all. So it matches exactly this, because you are clear on the pattern saying this is three digit, this is four digit, this is three digit. You already told using regular expression symbols. Now when you do that, it exactly matches only the one you want. And to way to fetch it, like for example, all you need to do is, like I said, just capture it in a variable. And after capturing it, all you need to do is just say obj dot group of one. And that should, okay, what does it say? Okay, see, when it doesn't match, what happens? So here it is. So one thing you should be very sure that if it is matching or not. So the way to look at it is, whenever it matches, it will give you something like this object. Okay. And the way to look at it is like object dot groups. And this groups have nothing. And there's another function group. Yeah. So this particular thing, there is no one, I think it is zero. So you can see the first match is zeroth. So this is how you can print the required match rather than use regular expression object. So we are mixing up things like regular expression symbol along with groups so that we can fetch the required. So we know that there is a match happened. In order to fetch it, as we know, group is the function to get each match occurred, like first match, second match, third match, like that. Okay. What is the use of backslash D? Backslash D, we already talked about it. I think you joined late. Backslash D represents a single digit, any digit from 0 to 9 characters. Okay, so what we are saying is any number, it could be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That one, I want to repeat three times. That means it will be three times. That is what it is. So it has to match this pattern. That's why it is. Okay, so there are some basic symbols like what I have taught here need to be aware before using regular expression in any language, not just Python. So backslash D just represents any of the character from 0 to 9. That is the main use. Now, how the web scraping thing works. Like for example, understand one thing, regular expression, how to display the output to matplot in character or graph, what command needed. There is no single command, Rajan. First you have to import the matplotlib, then you have to get the output, then you have to pump it in. It's not directly, there is no one single command. What is the return type of regular expression? It is, if it is a search, it will be re.match. Otherwise they are all regular expression objects. Okay. Now let's see, you know, like I said, this is a HTML page. I have downloaded this HTML page. in this HTML page, I want to fetch only the names. This is like a table, right? I want to fetch only the names and this ranking. So I have written code for it to do it. So let's say this is the HTML I have, where it has baby names and popularity, all that. Now understand one thing, regular expression by themselves can only do parsing by pattern matching and all, that's all. They cannot download your web page, they cannot crawl. No, that and all you have to do. So I already downloaded this in my system and kept it. So I'll show you whatever I have downloaded. So if you go to the, so where is it? So in this, if you see, this is the HTML I have downloaded, baby names 2010 HTML and all, and baby names, it's purely HTML page. From that HTML page, I'm getting the information. So this is my HTML. And in that HTML, I know what is the pattern of baby name. So if you see every baby, they have a rank, they have name, they have their first name, second name, their rank, first name, second name, like that. There's a pattern, TD, less than TD, less than TD. This is the pattern they have. There are a bunch of TDs. So all I need to do is write a regular expression to fetch the information from these bunch of TDs, isn't it? So this is what I have exactly written. First, let me run the program so you can see, then I'll explain about it. Okay, so let me, so this is my program where I say find baby names dot py. Then when I run it, it asked me what is the file name you want me to do. So I said baby names 2019.html, and that's it. So you see, it generated a nice report from me for me based on the data I have pulled. Popular names, male, these are all I fetched using regular expression, and it is able to give me the same thing like what HTML is showing me. That is the way I want, because I want to show to my client or whatever requirement. But you see, I extracted from a website. This is the same thing. Now comes to the question of what I did here. So let me show you that. Now, if you see, this is the code, what I have done. So first thing, enter file name to process. So it asked me the file name, which you have seen when I ran. Then I picked the output, the file name. I opened the file. I read the entire content of the file. Understand one thing, regular expression need as a string. That's why I have to read it as complete thing as a string. Now what I did, see, I used the re.search to search for the popular names, because if you see my output, there is this popular name already there at the heading. So I had to fetch it separately. It is not part of the normal pattern. So I fetched it, and I don't know the year, because here it says 2019. I didn't give it. If I run another program where I give baby names 2020.html, okay, there's no name that. Okay, baby names 2010.html. Let me run again. Baby names 2010.html. So now you see the year, it automatically changes. It is not fetching from my file, it is fetching from the data. So in order to fetch that, I need to know the year, right? So I'm fetching the year here by using re.search, and you can see the group we discussed, that is the exact thing I'm using here. Now we are done with the first line. Now what is the other thing? You have to fetch the baby names, right? So baby names, what is the pattern? I already showed you, there is a td td td, like that. There are patterns, right? Every td, the first one will be the rank, second one will be your first name, third one will be your last name. So I'm putting multiple D's, because this is to fetch the rank, this is to fetch the first name, this is to fetch the last name. I put a parenthesis. So when I put parenthesis and I'm doing find all, so I will get a bunch of, when I do find all means I'll get a bunch of these. This is what the find all output gives me. In that, all I need to do is first this, first this, first this, that's all. So but this find all gives me once I put a pattern. Now given that these are all available, I need to just do a formatting, and this is all in, I'm doing Python formatting, that's all. All I'm doing, if you see, is from the same baby names, I'm getting one by one, and I'm just showing it up. That's all. Okay, that's all. It is as simple as that. But before that, understand this file has to be downloaded, then you can write regular expression. So you can see how simple it is to fetch a male or female name or any kind of data which is on the website. You just need to download and put regular expression, and you get it very easily. If you don't do this way, right, the problem is you have to write a lot of code to split, cut, and all, and it might not work out properly. But here it is pretty simple if you know the pattern of it. Okay, see you all. Bye.